So here in Manchester, it's England versus Northern Ireland. It's Sean Murphy versus Mark Allen. It's first to six to reach the final of the Ladbrokes Players' Championship. Ricky Walden already through. He beat Barry Hawkins 6-3 this afternoon. The referee is Ben Williams. Expecting good stuff between these two. Tend to bring out the best in one another. Let's see what happens. Murphy then to start in frame one. Mike Allen alongside me this evening to enjoy it.
Yes, thank you, David. Great crowd in and great reception for these two boys. But having said all that, the head-to-heads is not good reading for Mark Allen. Ten-three to Sean Murphy. And the way Sean's been playing of late, you've got to put him favourite here this evening, but it's the best of 11 and this guy can play, we know that. Sean, we know, won in Dundee a few days ago, and he's trying his best to win back-to-back tournaments. He's certainly in the form to do that. But you can't discount this fella. Well, not that one, the one that's at the table, actually. You can't discount that fellow, either.
Well, there's something flying around in the arena. Mark Allen just trying to shoo it away.
Yeah, and I think it's a moth or something. I think it took up residence a couple of days ago.
Season ticket.
If these two guys bring their A games, this could be a really good match between them. Both good break builders, tactically very aware, of course, when they need it. But I think you've got to edge towards Sean in present form. Mark knows that his safety has to be good here this evening. He doesn't want to start giving Sean table time because, as we've seen, not only in Landno, but this week as well, that once he gets his hand on the table, he gets stronger and stronger. Had to fight all the way last evening, though, against Ben Wollaston. 4-3. And the scores there, and the live scores streaming than that, David. The 3-1 Sean led, he was, then Ben brought you back to 3-3.
It was a poor match, to be honest, and Wollaston probably should have won it, but he didn't, and Murphy's still here. Mark Allen didn't play great himself against Mike Dunn, but this is different, I think, the dynamic here, because they're playing another top player. No disrespect to the other two I mentioned, but they're expected to win those matches. They know that they've got to raise their games here to come through, and I suspect they will. Two players who like the big occasion.
I don't think the plan was quite on. The priority was to get the white back to the top cushion. Would have liked to have been tight, but it's pretty good. Like all arenas, this arena, also like Landon, is coming to its own now. We've gone down to one table. We did that during the quarterfinal stage. No distractions, concentrate on things ahead. These boys are playing for £18,000 here this evening. Ricky Walden already in the final, guaranteed £38,000 and a chance to win the £100,000 on Sunday. Looking to cover that red down the table. It's like he's played it pretty well. Yep. Well, there is that one. He might be able to get onto the black, actually, if he fancies it. He does like to attack. But as we know, there's a fine line between being attacking and being reckless. I think he's having a go. No, my apologies. I thought he was playing the one in front of that, actually. Yeah, that's pretty good. Well, there's the confidence of the man taking that on. That was a difficult pot. I thought he was playing away safety. I thought he was going to have to cover that red down the table, but he had a go. So this is the first real good chance for either players in this opening frame. Just get around the back of the black here.
One.
Well, he's a hit that slightly. That just looks a little bit tentative. I know it's the early days in this semi-final, but a little bit of a settling down period. They still need potting. Yes, all the way. But he's, well, he might be okay, actually. I think he's got a red here to the left middle.
Eight. No.
I was just saying there, David, you've got to put Sean Favourite in present form, but it would be no surprise if this guy wins this evening. He's very capable.
Well, I don't think it matters who you put Favourite. It's about what happens over the next couple of hours. I mean, Ricky Walden came here this week with no form at all, and he's in the final.
Yeah, true. Just shows you, doesn't it?
About who takes their chances. This is one for Mark Allen.
14.
He's not in Beijing next week. He didn't qualify with the China Open, so this is his last snooker before the championship. So it would be big in terms of confidence if he could take away the trophy tomorrow. Went in Bulgaria earlier in the year in the European Tour event. That obviously qualified him immediately for the finals here.
20.
Yes, well ensconced in the top 16 as well, so he'll be at Sheffield. So the that he doesn't have to worry about that, of course. Just concentrate on this event this weekend. Ooh, he's missed that one.
McAllen, 20.
Another full-blooded attempt from Murphy, but another one doesn't quite find its target.
Fair way off there as well.
1.
Didn't play that very well.
8.
I think he caught the wrong red, actually. I just wonder if you can see the one through the gap to the green pocket. Otherwise, he might just drop this one into the left centre, across for the black. But he might stay on the left-hand side of the table, actually.
No.
Yes, recovery.
Second chance then for Alan in this opening frame. Ooh, well, that must be a big bounce off the side cushion to finish there.
16.
Be surprised if he overhit it by that much. I think that did swing off the cushion.
I think it's end of break unless he plays a double into the left centre. Stuns down for the black.
Well, he's just dealt with one of the flying visitors there.
Mark Allen, 16.
Well, he'd be disappointed with that because it was a good red to the middle pocket.
Thank you.
Caught that beautifully. First, got right in behind the red. Well, he did catch that a little bit on the thick side. And he's put up a chance here for Sean to this right corner. And the problem is, there's a couple of reds he could take on, but what sort of colour can he get on? Unless he can get back for the blue. That's more like it. Well, eventually they're going to start going in. And now the chance has been handed to the Englishman.
Played superbly in the last 16 against Dominic Dalby, missed a ball in that match. Really top quality stuff. And that's why it was surprising he struggled a little bit last night. But he won, that's the main thing.
7.
Can't expect to play world-class stuff in every frame of every tournament. But we know, of course, we know the form's in there. We've been watching it to quite a bit the last couple of weeks. Of course, he went to land, didn't he, with no form really. Hadn't done that much this season, but as with Ricky Walden, you know, it comes out, these quality players, give them long enough, eventually they'll start to play well.
Well, I remember John Higgins, I think it was his third world title he won, David. I think he went to Sheffield with no form at all and finished all of a sudden, got there, felt really good, clicked and won the title. I think it was his third, might have been his fourth, but it's amazing, isn't it? You get there, you think, hang on. I feel really good, especially when you get to the quarters, then suddenly the semis, you think, and now I can win
17.
This.
Yeah, and it can happen the other way as well. Ding won those five titles 18. A couple of seasons ago, went to the Crucible, lost to Michael Wasley first round, so you just never know.
But once you do find that little purple patch, you you want to try and keep it going if you can. I mean, Stephen Hendry was probably the best at that. Even Steve Davis. They just continue to win matches and win tournaments week in, week out.
Yes, it was never enough for them, was it? Just how many trophies they won, they wanted more.
24.
Well, Stephen Hendry's trophy cabinet kept being rebuilt every year, getting bigger and bigger by the 12 months. And although he's 11 points behind here, Sean, he's just gone favourite in this opening frame. Not sure whether the red near the black goes, but if he gets on the black, he can nudge it away anyway.
31. 32.
Things have got those best of sevens out of the way, David, haven't they? They can be a little bit nervy, a bit edgy. Now it's the longer frames, they can settle into the, what we call their normal games.
Yes, it feels more like, a regular tournament. As you say, the sprints are out the way. One table, no distractions, longer matches. It's where these players arrive, these top players. Finals, two sessions, first to 10.
Well, it's going to be about this red near the black. We're not sure whether it goes from this angle. Just as the camera swung around there, I think it will.
51.
And he's going to need it.
52.
Well, obviously it does, because it's difficult to move it from there, so just done down past the pink.
57.
Well, Mark had a couple of chances early on in the opening frame.
57.
Couldn't quite take them, but it looks like the first frame is going to Sean Murphy.
58.
Well, he missed a couple. They weren't easy, the balls he missed, but he missed a couple, but... Alan, well, he was unlucky the second visit. He missed a red first visit, but second visit did get a big bounce. That meant he lost position.
65.
Yeah, long way to go.
67.
There is, but he didn't want Murphy to get his hand on the table straight away, the form he's been in.
Yeah, that was the danger.
70.
He's still got his lucky shoes on. I wonder if he wears them at home as well. He probably hasn't taken them off for 2 weeks.
74. 79. Foul.
Well, the wrong one went in, but 79 is a good contribution for Sean Murphy to take the opening frame. That's more like it. That's the sort of form he's been showing. Welcome back to Manchester. Sean Murphy 1, Mark Allen 0. Second semi-final of the Ladbrokes Players Snooker Championship. 6 needed to take Ricky Walden, who beat Barry Hawkins 6-3 earlier on today. Ben Williams, the referee, just setting the balls up for frame 2. Sean Murphy made 79 there in the opening frame after Alan had had a couple of half chances. It's not quite strictly come down, but here we are at this venue, which is filled during the week, and tomorrow, in fact, they've actually released extra tickets, so hopefully, well, it sounds like it will be full tomorrow for the final. Sean Murphy with those shoes could possibly get on Strictly. Maybe that's all part of the plan.
Thank you, frame two.
It's all about Strictly compotting this weekend.
So Alan finds himself a frame down.
Yes, good return there. Excellent. Just acknowledged there from Sean, little tap on the table. Good shot. Might be forced into going for this. It's difficult to... Well, he can't put the white to the top cushion. So the only way out is to pot his way out of trouble. Oh. Well, I mean, first of all, it just focused the mind, but what a touch that is to get the nudge on the black. Great pot. It was... I couldn't see any way out but that. Well, he was after the pack there. Obviously, just nudged that one on the way through. He might still take this red on. Let's just go over this left-hand side. Well, once again, don't be surprised if you take this on, which I think he is doing, and don't be surprised if it goes in. And he's gone for the black. One far away. Well, he's pushed the boat out there a little bit.
The key thing is, though, Mark Allen spotted this, is just how confident he is. Okay, he hasn't potted everything, but he's going for them, and he's going to continue to go for them. So when Allen gets chances, he's really got to try and put something together. And that's not good for the Antrim. That's exactly what I was saying. That wasn't absolutely straightforward, that pot, but... The way Murphy's playing, I'm afraid Allen just can't afford to miss.
No, and we saw that the other night, didn't we? When we did Sean against Dominic Dale, he really put Dominic under pressure not to miss. We've seen all the great players do that down the years. You know, Steve Davis was a master, Stephen Hendry was a master at that. All the others, Ronnie, Mark Williams, John Higgins, they've all done it.
Eight.
Yes, Allen knows this is not likely to be a match where he's going to get three or four chances a frame. He might only get one. He's had one there. Didn't pot the red.
Might not get another one.
Nine.
Especially when you're powering him in at that speed, at that angle. That's ultra confident. Well, I'll tell you what, that's gone slightly wrong. Because he was looking for a cannon there to leave a red to either corner fairly straight, and he's just gone a little bit awkward. He played on the cannon. Well, it's the red that's to beyond, actually. That one just this side of the cue ball. Still okay, but it's awkward. Well, it's gone wrong.
17.
Still has a shot on the black, though, and the blue. Well, this is no gimme, but the rewards are there if it goes in. Oh. Well, the thing is, there was just no hesitation. He had a 24. Couple of looks at it and thought, okay then, bang, get down, bang, in the pocket.
Yes, it already looks 25. Like he's got his one bad match, if you like, out of the way last night. This is much more in keeping with the way playing of late. I've always enjoyed watching Sean. He's always looked like a top player, even before he was, when he was a teenager. He stride around the table, but of 30. Course he's got the titles now to back it up. Mark Allen's well aware of that.
Thirty-one.
Seems to have got more of that killer instinct back now. He had a few years ago.
38.
It could be 2-0. The rods are not ideally placed, but they're still in pretty good position. Well, he could be sitting this one out as well. Well, there's reds available at this left corner. He might just screw into the match, just where the gap is there. The worst thing is to find that gap. I wouldn't have thought he could do that. Any sort of contact. In fact, a cannon into the red, the one furthest away of the two together, would be perfect. One has gone the other way. He's decided to play on it, which is fair enough. Very close to the winning line here in frame two.
55.
And as you made the point a few minutes ago, David, you know, Mark gave Sean early table time in frame one.
Yes, he's also seen him, as I said, going for his shots. And it meant that when Alan was on that red, which wasn't an absolute gimme by any means, but he knew that he'd be leaving him in, and this has been the result. Already snookers required. Just seeing them so clearly, isn't he? Potting them so cleanly.
Well, he ran out of position, didn't he? But he didn't really hesitate with that difficult black into the right corner, knowing the red was over the middle. He took it on, went in, and it's one in the frame.
76.
You know, he's not refusing a lot, and most of it's going in. Every chance of the century.
81.
He's another player closing in on 400. 82. He's on 379 at the moment.
91.
Might play on the red here. Might try and nudge it over the corner. I think he'll play in behind it. Well, it's what we call having the cue ball on a string. Some days you have it on a rope, but this guy's got it on a string. But he's missed that one.
He obviously wanted a century, but 97, very impressive from Sean Murphy. Great start for him. Two big breaks in the first two frames. Mark Allen bang under early pressure here in Manchester. Sean Murphy leading by 2-0. Sean Murphy breaks of 79 and 97. From the Englishman. So it'll be interesting to see what happens the next time Mark Allen gets a chance. Can he take it? He's going to have to start taking them soon.
Yeah, 2-0 in no time at all. It's just about 30 minutes playing time, probably less than that actually.
The danger for Allen is that Murphy just runs away with it. He's done that in a few matches of late. But of course he has to keep up the pressure. I mean, in that final in Clanvin, though, he was 4-1 up against Stuart Bingham, looking like he's heading for an early night. In the end, of course, as we know, he scrambled through in the decider. These matches can turn round. But it's on Mark Allen, as I say. It's down to him, if he gets a chance, to make something from it.
Sean Murphy to break. Thank you.
Well, I think he can see this red here on the left-hand side. He'll be going for this. The black's available. No. Wasn't easy from distance. No real damage done. Sean here will be looking to push on. An interval, of course, after four frames. Too thick. I think he's got away with that a little bit actually. And Sean could play the red into the left corner and then just go over for the pink, and you can't really leave anything on. He's just checking that now. I think he might be having a go at this. Yeah, he's just checking where he wants the cue ball, not to leave anything on. Well, it was a chance to get in, but it was a little wide, but it's okay. It's Ben Williams, our referee. Well, that was miles too thick. Could have easily have left Mark an easier one than this. Yes, there is the red on the right hand side, but it's risky, no guarantee of a colour. Oh, he's found that one. Great shot. Could deal with a cannon into something though. That's unlucky. He's not just quite having the best of it at the moment. In the first frame he had the chance and then got that big bounce off the side cushion.
Mark Allen, one.
Well, that was a good red and it deserved more. But so often we know that this game can become a patience game when needed. I think the obvious one is the one that's nearest the black on this top cushion, but how does he get there? Might be looking for gap between the red and the pink. If he catches anything on the way through, could be expensive. Well, he's walked away from that one in disgust. No, what were you saying, David, about good chance for Mark Allen?
Well, this is certainly that, isn't it?
One.
He said he didn't feel he played that well, but he's a great competitor, Allen. He really is. He gets stuck in. Very combative.
A little bit concerned for the red on the right. right hand side. I think it's okay with that one. We'll have to hold for the pink.
Nine.
Yeah, he's one of those players. It's, you just think he can have an, a little bit of a bad trot, and then suddenly it clicks into gear. And this is one of those occasions where he could do that.
15.
Just putting the rest on the spider here at extra height.
Okay.
Well, again, just skimmed off them slightly because the black is only available to one corner. So he might have to play on the blue here. But if you can just put together a 70 or 80 and put this frame on the board, that will certainly settle him down. Expectant crowd here with these... two great players. Well, you can see the pink goes into that corner. That's what he's played on. He's played it well. Again, ideally, dead straight on the pink would have been perfect. Pink still goes. Well, he didn't mess about with that one. Chose to attack and get them open. Not ideal position on this pink or blue, but you could pop the pink and just use blue as the stopper. He's got the red over the corner pocket. Well, he doesn't skim off the blue. I think if he hits it fullish, it should be okay. Now, does he have this one to left corner?
37.
He just came off blue more than I thought he would have done, but there might be another one that goes, actually. Yes, well, he's not on the one near the corner pocket. Well, the danger here is catching the other one on the way through. Well played. He's having to work hard here because he's not getting the cue ball in the right spot. He might have to go around the table. And if he does decide to go in and out of the book, there's plenty of colours down there that he could hit. Nicely held.
44.
Well, I don't know. I would suggest take the one there, the pocket. Well, this is a real good chance now to put his first frame on the board.
Yes, and the way Murphy started, Mark Allen knows he's basically got to win these frames in big breaks himself. That's the standard we're at now. That's worked out okay.
52.
Murphy's such a long potter, you know, you think he played a good safety, you leave him any sort of pot on, he invariably knocks it in. So he's got to take these out. He's got a great chance here to win this frame now. He's had to work hard for these. Great start to this match.
Six. Yeah, you just took the words out of my mouth, Dave. You're saying, you know, with third frame in, what a standard this is.
61.
Two players who enjoy the big stages. Sean Murphy, of course, former world champion. Mark Allen's won two big ranking titles, plus five European Tour events.
68.
Well, once more, the audience had done their calculations. They knew that was frame ball.
69.
Also now. Well, he definitely needed this. There's no doubt about that. Now he'll feel involved.
It's an occasion where they're raising each other's games. It could be a really good night, this. It's certainly a great start.
Yeah, 75. And it could still be two all at the interval. One more frame to come after this 76. One before they go into a 15-20 minute interval.
Well, the important thing for Allen is he's done what he had to do, which is just remind everybody there's a match on and that he can produce high-quality snooker himself.
83.
Well, we didn't get the century off of Sean. Are we about to get one here off Mark?
84.
Well, he took one out earlier. I think his mate's back for revenge.
Yeah.
91. 92.
Allen's had two centuries in the tournament so far. This looks like number three coming up.
Well, he's taken these really 99. Well. He knew that he had to. Every credit.
Yeah, really good break that. There was just a couple of hurdles to get over early on. But that is a very emphatic way to get on the scoreboard. As I said, he's a great competitor and often produces his best snooker when he absolutely has to.
He
was always destined for big things, Mark Allen. He won all the titles you could win as an amateur, the World Amateur, the Europeans, the European Juniors, all the Northern Ireland titles at the various age ranges. Well, a delightful break this. 134. Terrific stuff from Northern Ireland's Mark Allen. Even Sean Murphy was applauding that. That's how good it was. He has arrived in this match in a big way. So it's game on here in Manchester. Sean Murphy leads Mark Allen. One. Cracking stuff between these two. Murphy 79-97. Those are his breaks. Then Mark Allen a 1-3-4. So this is last frame before the mid-session interval. And it's been cracking stuff.
Certainly has. Yeah, we said he needed that, but, you know, OK, the 1-3-4 was superb, but more importantly, he's got some table time under his belt, and now he looks in the groove. So, looking forward to the rest of the evening, the way things have gone so far.
Well, the important thing there was that he showed everybody, including, of course, Sean Murphy, that if the chess came, he could take it, and he took it really well.
Yeah, wasn't it nice to see Sean applauding that break at the end there as well? I mean, Sean is a gentleman, we know that, and he knew how good that was.
And, thank you.
He applauded the skills of his opponent. So frame four, the last before the interval. Which way will it go?
Whatever happens, of course, Murphy's in Beijing next week. Mark Allen didn't qualify. Lost to Mitchell Mann, 5-2 in the qualifiers, which was a shock, obviously. But and I didn't see the match, so I can't say anything about it. But it is a bit of a leveller, those qualifying setups. So big leisure centres, not where the top player would be, as Murphy takes another long one. Mark Williams also was a casualty. Most of the rest of them got through.
Just got Chandler drawing for London play, actually, David. Sean Murphy plays David Grace in the first round. But there is an interesting one, thinking about all the provisionals and the ranking list and all that. And it's a possible that Michael White and Stephen Maguire, who are bidding for a top 16 place before Sheffield, could meet in the second round. Now, that's going to be massive.
Yes, a bit of tension in that one. Maguire's got to reach the semis to get in the top 16, so he'd have to win that match. We'll have it for you from Monday morning here on Eurosport, on all week, of course.
Well, he's just pushed that red out, which is allowing Mark to take it to the left middle. I wonder whether he's contemplating one off the other there. I don't think he can hit it clean enough to pot it direct. I wonder if he's playing one off the other, or thinking about it, and then trying to stay on the black. I don't think he can see enough of that to play it clean. And then might be able to get a cannon into the red, right to the black. I think this is one off the other. That's what he tried. Well, I know both these lads like to have a go, but I'm not sure about that one. I think the red to the left middle might have been better. He hasn't left an easy chance here for Sean. Well, obviously, if that had gone in, he was definitely on this red, but he still might be, actually. Yeah, came right across that one.
One.
Couldn't guarantee position. But he can make it awkward now.
Yeah, that's friendly.
Well, what about that for touch? That was brilliant. This is awkward. it's not that easy to get safe from, because he's limited as to how far he can come down this side cushion. That was a wonderful touch there from the Irishman to put the cue ball there. Well, I think he's playing two cushions and trying to lay in at the side of the pack, just below the pink. Got to miss the middle pocket by an inch or so. He's caught the knuckle.
Foul and a miss. Mark Allen, four.
Well, the miss has been called, but I don't think it'll go back. He was a fraction away there, actually. And another half an inch down that cushion, I think it would have been OK.
One.
Well, that seemed a bit springy as well. I've said all week on this table the back cushion's been very lively. Not bad.
Six.
That could have easily landed on the cushion.
Seven.
Well, we saw what he did in the last frame. Can he do the same here? The pack needs some attention, of course, which I think he's about to give it.
Fourteen. 15.
Shake of the head, just landed a little bit straight, but he can play on the red to the middle, or he can come around it. Well, he's played on the bottom red, that's fair enough. This is definitely going 22. To scatter them. He's just one of those players, though, David, isn't he? Even if he does get a couple of frames behind, you just expect him to keep coming at you. You know, he's not one to panic these days. He just gets on with the game and, you know, he keeps positive.
That's not worked out, though, really.
Yes, he has a fearless quality to him. I think it is something he shares with his great Northern Ireland compatriots of old, but wasn't happy there. The white didn't quite come back as intended. And if he's going to take this on, it's tough.
Yeah, I think somebody just sneezed on the backswing there as well, which didn't help. But the thing is, if you really concentrate, and you don't hear anything anyway, once you've got yourself what you call in the zone, it's just you and the table, really. Oh, it should be.
It's going to be safety, but as I said earlier, it's going to have to be safe, because the way Murphy's been playing this week, these last couple of weeks, anything that's on, he takes on.
Mark Allen, 23.
Left in hand, but over the green.
But I'm sure disappointed not to be able to continue that break. The way Murphy played a 2-0, I think he'd be disappointed with 2-2 at the interval. So it's an interesting frame, this. The interval can often set the sort of psychological tone for a match. Allen would be delighted, of course.
Absolutely. He's probably thinking, I want it 3-1. Oh, hang on. Well, first glance, it's not too bad. Okay, he's got the red near the blue, but if it had caught that one fuller and left it onto this corner, That could have spelled danger. But Mark still might take this one onto the yellow pocket. He could stun down and still be on the yellow. The danger Mark's got is the fact if he takes it on and misses it, he's bound to leave this red on the right-hand side, and it would be available for Sean. It's always a fine line. If this goes in, it might win the frame. Well, it was wide. He's got some distance between the cue ball and the reds, but like I said, this red on the right-hand side is on. Well, what can you say? I mean, it was one of those, when Mark was lining up that red, I thought if that doesn't go in and he leaves that one, he could be in danger. But, you know, over the last couple of weeks, Sean has really refused anything. And I say a high percentage of them have been going in.
Didn't he cue that well, though? I mean, hole for the black as well. Superb.
Beautiful. Just stroked it, didn't he?
So he has his chance here in frame four. Eight.
Nine.
That's the sort of dynamics of this game as well, David, isn't it? You don't want to show any negativity towards your opponent, but on the other hand, you've got to play 16. Quite cute when you know your opponent's cueing well.
17.
I know one thing, it's been terrific snooker. Really high quality.
Yeah, so enjoyable. And this is what it's all about, this crowd here in Manchester. They must be loving this, as we are.
24.
This has been a treat so far. It's a question of, will it be 3-1 or 2 apiece at half time?
25.
Normally, Sean hasn't been sort of giving up these chances when in and amongst around the black spot.
33.
Well, there's a red on the cushion, but he's not going to need it if he takes big colours with these four open reds.
33. He's missed that one, though.
John Murphy, 33.
That was never in.
No, that was a big surprise. OK, he was a little high on it, but you still expect him to knock this in. I'm sure he did as well.
Well, he's covered the pocket for the straighter one. This is a little bit more difficult. And he's missed that one. But the pocket is covered. But there is another red on this right-hand side. What a chance there for Mark Allen. He might rue that one if this goes 3-1. Yeah, Sean was a little bit fortunate not to leave the straighter red. Had to play that one instead. Still fancying him to get it. Yeah, I think the red just left of the pink goes to this the right corner. He's also had a look at this black. I think if he gets tight to the cushion, the black will pot. In as much that he's going to need the red that's nearest the black. Now then, let's see how he plays this. He could stay on the pink, but I think if he's got a chance to get tight to this cushion, he'll play it.
Four.
Perfect. And this opens up the pocket. This could be about to go 3-1 at the mid-session interval.
Eleven.
He didn't leave an easy red when he missed the black, 12. But it was a half chance, and in a match of this quality, I'm afraid they've got to go in. It's just been that sort of snooker.
19.
Won't need the awkward 20. Green. He would have done the damage by then. Well, Mark would be a little bit annoyed with himself that he hasn't got into the interval at two apiece. He had a couple of half chances in the opening frame. Came up well with the century in the third, but that was a great chance there to level. So it's going to be, well, if he gets this red and colour, it's going to be advantage to 25. The Englishman at half time.
This is frame ball.
26.
Well, a cracking start to this semi-final. Sean Murphy, two big breaks for 2-0. Mark Allen, a century in the third frame. This one, though, could have gone either way, and that, I think, is what Mark Allen will think about
33.
In the 15-minute interval.
35.
Well, can we cancel the interval and just carry on? Especially with the way they're playing. Well, he's missed that.
Sean Murphy's 35 and the frame.
Sean Murphy goes into the interval with a 3-1 lead after a very interesting and high-quality start to this semi-final. Mark Allen with the 1-3-4 in the third frame. Just could quite make the most of his chances in the fourth. And Murphy leads 3-1. That means that when they come back 15 minutes from now, Murphy will need three frames to go through to the final of the Players' Championship. So, Sean Thank Murphy you. 3, Mark Allen 1, 6 required to take on Ricky Walden in the
Thank
final
you,
tomorrow.
Five. Sean Murphy to break.
Well, I was going to say, I don't know about simply red, but I think Mark Allen's looking for some simple reds to start this next frame. And he might have one here. The last thing Sean wanted to do when coming back is just to play a break-off shot, I should say, and leave things on. Well, we saw what he did in the third frame. He's lost the white there. That seemed to ping off the cushion. This table has been very quick all week. I think he's okay here, though. You can just drop this in dead weight for the black. Well, if he decides to come off the cushion, that's fair enough. He did have the angle on the red there to do that, but it's a good early chance in this fifth frame.
Twelve. 13.
Well, he could certainly have told himself in the interval that he didn't do 20. Much wrong, really. And, of course, he had the century, so he'd played well in the frame he won. Just that fourth that could have gone either 21. Way.
Into the pack here. Good angle. Plenty of spin. Well, I think this one goes, so it definitely goes to the middle, but it might go past 28. The pink to the corner. He's got this other one as well, but I think he'll play the straighter one to the yellow pocket. Oh, dear me.
28.
Well, he came right across that. He walked away from it straight away. Don't know, he looked okay, but he just seemed to put a quick one in. Well, Sean's looking at a possible plant here to the left middle. Now, that's not one that Mark actually had a look at when he was trying to get onto the black. I think that's on. Ooh, I think if it had just hit it a little bit harder, it might have just stayed on this line. One to the right middle now. Not hit it. He's not hit it. Well, he's totally disgusted with himself over the last two shots. They've been very poor. Look at the guy's expression in the background as well. He's thinking, oh, dear me, what was that?
Wow.
It's always disappointing, I think, for players to do two of them in a row. One of them's bad enough, of course, but he had a chance to make amends there, and he'll be fuming, Alan, particularly, of course, if Murphy can make a big break off it, and there's a great chance to do that here.
Yeah, could have been 2-2. It's 3-1. Could have been 3-2.
Six.
Might be 4-1.
Seven.
Yes, they hold themselves to high standards. That's because, of course, they consistently produce high standards, these top players, and particularly at this stage of a tournament with the really big money coming in. You want to play your best stuff and cut out errors like that.
Well, these boys are playing for £18,000 this evening, and the possibility, of course, of the £100,000 tomorrow.
18.
We know that Ricky Walden is already there, but who's going to play against him? That's the big question. I think whoever comes through here this evening, David, I think it'll be a good final tomorrow because everybody's playing well, aren't they? You know, and we know it's the run into
18.
Sheffield and the World Championship, but everybody seemed to, you know, there's two or three players. Ding Junhui's been playing well, you know. Stuart Bingham's been a little bit in and out, but you never know. He could just find it before he gets back to Sheffield to defend. And
19.
But, you know, the Sheffield's going to be really interesting this year.
Well, 3 weeks. Tonight, Stuart Bingham will be playing his second session as defending champion at the Crucible.
Can't wait for the draw on that Thursday. Once all the qualifiers are finished on the Wednesday evening, the draw is made on the Thursday. Oh, he's got a kick there. And it's left himself high on the black. Now he's missed one of these already.
If anything, he's even higher this time than he was with the one he missed.
Yeah. He's missed that one.
John Murphy, 27.
Well, would you believe it? He was a little bit unlucky. He got the kick, which took the pace out of the white. Still expect him to pot that, though.
Well, he's actually overcut it that time. He's sort of overcompensated, if you like. But what a let-off for Mark Allen.
What?
Murphy a little unlucky with the kick, though.
Didn't fancy him to miss the black, not the second time. And this is not ideal either. He's just finished a little bit straight on the yellow. Looking at the blue now, isn't he? No, he's looking, actually looking at the black. Well, it's not a bad cannon, but he's pushed the other red safe. Eight. Yeah, well, with high value colours with these four reds in the table, he won't need it. Sean will need a snooker. That sounded like a nine. Kick as well. Just to make amends for that earlier miss.
Young child started to cry. Mark Allen said that's the way I feel as well.
Twenty-five.
Now he could play the red off the cushion here, but doesn't have to take the risk, doesn't need it. 22. Well, he's been a little bit lucky there. Yeah, he's just put his hand up to apologise because he's definitely 32. Played on the red to the corner, but it doesn't matter. Just doing the calculations. 33 the lead, so pink or black will be enough.
33.
He'd like the red in as well, because it stops the play on for snookers. Murphy needs two 39. At the minute. That'll do it. So the missed black from Sean Murphy has proved costly, and Mark Allen delighted because, of course, he missed a couple of reds and was not feeling good about that.
Mark Allen 40.
He's feeling a lot better now. He's won the fifth frame, and Sean Murphy's lead is cut to 3-2. Fascinating battle, high quality match developing between these two fine players. Murphy leads, but only 3-2.
Дивно на Евроспорт 1 и Евроспорт 2.
It's 3-2 then. Sean Murphy, the man in front, had a chance for 4-1. He was a little unlucky. Got a kick, left him more awkward on the black than he would have liked. Missed it, and Mark Allen delighted to get the chance and took it nicely to win that fifth frame. First to six reaches the final.
Well, this next frame really becomes important now. There's the score line on the arena monitors, and the next frame could really set the tone as to which way this match might go. It's one of the monitors that the players can have a look at, see what the scoreline is, and of course the audience can see what's going on as well.
Thank you, frame
we'll
six.
Be looking at that one, we'll be looking at another one. Well, Mark delighted to get that one on the board. He could have easily been 4-1 behind there. Now, can he level up?
Well, Murphy's not going to stop taking them on, but that was really tough.
Well, I'm not sure if the interval was good for him, to be honest. He wanted to stay out there. He's certainly missed a couple since then. Doesn't really want that in. Well, that was an attack in safety there from Sean Murphy. That's a natural game, Alex. You just want to get bogged down into a tactical battle with Mark. You just want to try and win these frames in one visit if you can. Which he was doing in Llandudno and also this week. Well, he did get the ball kiss, but no damage done. Well, he's happy to have a go. But he's missed that one. What a chance that was. Now, has he left anything? Well, not the one to the left. I think he's looking at the one to the right. Well, all of a sudden, they're not going in for Sean Murphy.
Five.
Well, Sean's just opened the door a little bit here for Mark Allen.
Six.
Well, unless he's on this red nearest the pink, I think that's gone wrong. He's played a foolish cannon there to stay on a red to the middle, but, well, can he see this one? There's nothing there. That was not a good cannon there. Well, there's nothing there at all. He's going to have to play a good safety. Well, unless he's, what's he playing here? Plant? He's trying the one near the cushion.
Mark Allen.
That was risky. That was really risky, but, well, another good missed opportunity there.
Seems in this match that because one player's going for everything, the other is as well. There didn't seem to be any thought there to play safe. He's given Murphy this chance.
One.
And sure, Murphy needs to steady the ship a little as well, because I wouldn't say he's gone off the boil, but certainly he's not quite producing the snooker he was pre-interval. But we must remember there's pressure on these two. There's a lot of money at stake this weekend, the prestige of winning a tournament, eight, particularly for Murphy, to win back-to-back ranking titles. That would be a feather in his cap, because it's quite rare these days that players do that.
Nine.
Yeah, he's sitting at number three in the world. Number four in the world, as I said at the moment. If he wins this weekend, he will go to number three, above Neil Robertson.
That, of course, will affect his Crucible seeding, although the China Open will come into play as well.
Yeah. Yes, Mark Allen not there, but Sean plays David Grace in the opening round.
14.
I think I'm right in saying, David, the four semi-finalists here, their matches have been held back slightly for China.
Well, they can't play realistically until Wednesday. They won't be flying until Monday. Mm. Can't really play on the day they land. So, but of course, there's six rounds to negotiate, so you'd have to certainly play at least twice in one day. So that's the consequences of doing well this week. It's not ideal, of course, but it's better than it used to be when you have to wait 6 weeks for a tournament.
17.
We'd like to hold the white that side, but obviously the cue ball's near to the cushion. He's just checking if he runs through. Well, that's the downward strike, and he's going to run through. He might hit the black.
18.
Well played. I mean, that was a difficult shot to play, but he made it look easy. And there is a red to the right middle. Yeah, just going back to that with the lines with the success. It's not a bad problem to have, is it? He's picking up a cheque for 100,000.
Put it this way, he can probably afford to fly business to Beijing.
Yeah.
After the couple of weeks he's had.
Absolutely.
Bit of leg room. Just remember to pack the shoes. That's the key thing.
I think that'll be the first thing going in.
Oh, he's missed the pack.
Amazing.
33.
The problem now is he's going to probably open one or two of these reds. Let's look at this again. Didn't get enough arc on the cue ball there. And he'll be opening up reds, so he's got to be careful. In fact, I think he could probably just come off top cushion first and lay into them gently. Now the yellow is off its own spot, more difficult to get in behind the colour from that side.
Sean Murphy.
This looks pretty tasty though. This looks pretty tasty. Oh, what a time to play one of those. I mean, he actually missed the pack and found himself in a bit of trouble there, but he's played one.
See, play safe and he can get it safe. Haven't seen many in the match, but that was a cracker.
Yeah. That's not too bad either. Although, could see Sean take this on. I don't know how straight it is, but he could certainly take the black on from the other side. He might just be able to pot this and bounce the white off the cushion a little bit. Too wide. But he knew that he had the knowledge of covering that red with the black. Well, you know, if a pot presents itself, he's going to have a go at it. It's as simple as that. Has he left a plant? Well, that's a big mistake from Sean Murphy because he took the red on, but he didn't even look at that plant. Oh!
Mark Allen, one.
Well, was that a bad contact or just a bad shot? From his point of view, he certainly didn't like it. Well, I think that was just a bad miss. I didn't see a kick there.
No, well, it certainly wasn't an obvious one, put it that way. He seemed to blame the black for it as he walked back to his seat. But it's got to that stage of the match, I think, where it's just getting a bit edgy.
This could be a key shot. Oh, wow. What's happened there?
John Murphy won.
Is that another bad miss or was it a bad contact? Well, that did bounce. I don't think the black did from Mark Allen, but that one did.
One.
Didn't really expect Sean to be that far away from the pocket with the pink. And, well, none of these are gimmies either. There's pressure on anything that he takes on here. He's taking the blue on.
Hang on.
Oof. Just wondered whether there's a bit of side transfer on there. Might have flipped it in, but... Well, as you say, David, it's all just got a little bit edgy, hasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, that blue, that wasn't an easy pot, but there was definitely pressure on it, particularly what had happened a couple of minutes prior to that in this frame. So tension has come to bear here.
Yeah, I think one of them just needs to stand back here and just take a deep breath.
Well, he's got a pretty good cue ball. Looking like a big frame, this.
Well, those stats are not too clever, are they? Not for players of this quality. Normally much higher than that. And we know that both players have been struggling here this evening with their long potting. But the rotor just needs one player to pot one and get in, and it should be frame over. Now, I wonder whether he might take on this right-hand red. It's a big pocket with the blue there. If he can bounce this red off the cushion, doesn't have to play it clean. If he can hit the cushion about, what, 18 inches from the pocket, it might go in off the blue. It's possible. Well, he went for it direct, but it's a good cue ball. Well, Mark Allen's got plenty of support in here this evening.
Yes, Murphy used to live quite close out in Sale. Now we're based in Nottingham.
Well, as Mark sits in his chair, this is not easy to get safe from, actually, for Sean. Oh, he's played one. Only just missed the blue, but that he's played that very well indeed. Yes, the audience appreciating that one. Again, he's left a little tempter here on the right-hand side. Looks like he's had a go at this one as well. Oh. Well, he just seems to be getting up off the shot pretty quickly, Mark. He needs to sort of, I don't know what's happening here, just needs to sort of try and settle down a little bit. Walked away from that one as well. Well, it wasn't clean, but it went in. That is the main thing.
Right. Well, is this the moment where Murphy just reasserts himself? He's seen Alan get a bit edgy. To be fair, they've both been edgy, but this is a definite chance. All the reds out in the open. He's already in front by 20.
Well, you would think so. You never know. There could be another twist.
I think that one difference is, you know, he's just won a tournament, so he knows he's playing well. He's got that confidence to draw on.
Seven.
He's always had terrific strength of character, Sean Murphy.
Eight.
Yeah, just had a quick look at the pink. It does go to the centre. And this is where they like to be, just close in, you know, little run-throughs, stun shots. This is the sort of positions that they practice hundreds of times in the club. They just put the reds around the black and the pink spot.
14.
And just keep tight control of the cue ball.
15.
Wanted a fuller contact on the red there.
Blue ball.
Determined to try and put this frame on the board. Well, I suppose really that was the only chance Mark Allen had there in this one. If Sean had missed that blue with the rest, can't see him missing from here now.
21.
Well, a litany of chances on both sides, but in the end Murphy knocked in a cracking red to that green bag. And the pressure mounts on Mark Allen now, because the next frame, if Murphy wins that as well, 5-2, he's a big favourite to reach the final.
28, 33, 35, 38.
Well, they both had a little wobble here, but it's Murphy who's managed to compose himself again. He waited 2 years to win another ranking title after the 2014 World Open. Could it just be 2 weeks?
47.
Until the next one.
41.
So Sean Murphy wins a pretty edgy sixth frame. Importantly for him, he gets his two-frame advantage back, and the next frame, frame seven, is huge in the context of this match, because Murphy only needs two more and he'll be in the final. Mark Allen with it all to do here. It's Murphy who leads in Manchester by 4-2. So 4-2 to Sean Murphy. As I say, this next frame, huge for Allen. He knows the confidence that Murphy has. If he leads 5-2, then he'd expect to complete the job. That was a very nervy frame, but in the end Murphy did pot a good red and did enough to get it on the scoreboard. I'm sure Ricky Walden wouldn't mind a comeback. He wouldn't mind a 5 each tonight. Of course, he beat Mark Allen in the final of the International Championship a couple of seasons back. That was a terrific performance from Ricky. Plenty in tonight. This is the best attendance today that we've had all week, and tomorrow there'll be even more here. They've released extra seats, in fact, which is good to see.
Thank you, frame 7. Sean Murphy to break.
A little bit better. Let's cover the reds with the green there. Black only goes into one corner. Well, that's not too good. The safety has to be better than that, because as I've said already this evening, that if there's a pot on, Sean will be taking it on. There's no doubt about that. And he can get himself onto the black here. It seems that he's got it back. David mentioned that the wobble was there, but he's become the predator again. Great pot. He's got the perfect angle. Just split those two reds on the black spot here. Oh, but he's missed the black.
One.
That's very kind of a gentleman to shout rubbish. And I suppose he can do a lot better out there, can he?
One.
It may have been that Murphy was just paying a little bit too much attention to the cannon. Just slightly took his eye off the pot. But either way, Mark Allen knows for him now this is an important visit. Just looking to settle down again after that nervy last frame.
Nine. 16.
Well, he's had a massive kick there, and the white has totally stopped. How unlucky is that? I mean, it's so annoying for a player that you're in and amongst them like this. Look at that. I mean, he's just taken off and just gone nowhere. Well, now he's got to find a good safety. I mean, he could come off the side cushion and try and just hit the green. Give that a couple of goes, and if he doesn't, then he's still got the black to come back to. I think he should try and hit the green here. But he wants to be at the table potting balls, and that was so unlucky. I mean, if he plays this well, he could still get the snooker behind the green.
Green ball. Mark Allen, 17.
Well, he'll settle for that. And there's Sean taps the table and saying, well played, but he would still like to be around the black spot, that is for sure. Again, it wasn't really close. So another chance here for the Irishman.
Yeah.
red to get in. Well, it's not a problem, this. He's landed slightly the wrong side. He can drop it in for the right-hand red. Get himself onto the black. I thought he might have gone a little bit further than that.
Six. Seven.
Well, he thought he'd lost the white there for a minute. But he has left himself slightly hampered.
Fourteen. 15. 22.
Well, he was unlucky with the earlier kick, but he's himself nicely back in here and looking good to win. As I said before the frame began, an important frame for him.
Yeah, I suppose this is a little bit of justice as well when he had that kick.
Because if Murphy had gone 5-2 in front, the way he was playing, he'd have fancied 6-2. But it's game on again. As long as he can now close this out. It has to be said, the contacts today, more than most of the week, have got to be said, have been not kind. Been a lot of kicks today. Maybe the weather has played a part in that. I don't know.
Yeah, well, we heard the rain, didn't we, during the afternoon session? The first semi-final. That really did come down. So a bit of damp in the air can make the difference. That was not a great contact there, right? Still has an angle on the black here to play a little cannon. Just catch the two reds right of the pink would be perfect. Well, make sure of the black anyway, whatever happens.
15. Done that. Well done. So he needs this red, and it's snookers required. Good contribution. At exactly the right time. 47. Could have done with the black. Could have done with the points there.
47.
So only one snooker to tie. He might regret missing that.
48.
The black goes in, it's three snookers.
48. And the colours are in good positions to lay snookers. Yeah, I think Mark might have just got a little bit ahead of himself there. And we've seen frames won from these positions. Just look where that green is. I mean, imagine if Sean gets four reds, four blacks, he could stun him behind the green from the yellow. But he's missed the pack because he took the black in the corner of the pocket.
Hey.
Now he's got to find a good safety. 8. Brought the red up the table, That's not too clever. I think it could be frame over.
Yes, not one of his better visits, it's got to be said.
One.
So the miss black made no difference. It's going to be 4-3. I say that, Murphy still may play on. He needs three snookers. He may have seen enough. He has seen enough. So Alan then makes it closer again. He needed to produce something in that frame. He was unlucky earlier on with the kick, but his next chance he made the most of. And this semi-final remains fascinating. Sean Murphy still two frames away from winning it, but Mark Allen has won that one. So he now trails Sean Murphy. I think one of the more vocal spectators has just been invited to leave. He didn't sound too happy about it, but anyway, it's made everyone else laugh.
Well, you can always watch in the pub down the road.
Yes, probably not his first bit of the day, to be fair, to that watering hole.
He's upset, isn't
he? Well, it takes all sorts. Anyway, the main thing, of course, is what's happening on the table. It's 4-3, and in fact, Dawn and Mark just having a little chat, I think, about it.
Yeah, but the thing is, David, it's off-putting for the players, and it can be off-putting for the crowd as well. Come here to watch a match, haven't they? You know, you don't need an idiot in the audience, given large, you know.
Well, this is why all the people, including some players who say snooker should be like darts in terms of the atmosphere, are just plain wrong. Because imagine what it would be like if everyone was behaving like that.
You still hear me in the background?
You just hang on a bit.
You can see these two are friendly, but it's unusual in a match to be having a chat.
I think we're all right now. Yeah. We're okay. Thank you, frame eight. Mark Allen to break.
Well, it's taken a little bit of the tension out of the evening, but anyway, we carry on. It's 4-3 to Murphy.
Yeah, he might have had a liquid lunch and an afternoon coming into this evening.
Yeah, the atmosphere at snooker is made by the quiet. Fans get involved, of course, they applaud and you can hear the gasps and everything else, but snooker has survived this long with this atmosphere. It would be a terrible shame to change it. The shootout's different, but that's a different tournament. And I'll tell you, a lot of people don't like it either. Don't like that atmosphere.
Well, to be honest, I think power snooker was even worse. For me, that was a total waste of time.
Yes, I don't think we're going to hear from that again.
No, well, I don't think the players, there's no way you're going to do what you did over the years to get where you are, then be just totally abused by people who've had a few drinks. That is not on. Just a little bit wide. I just wonder whether he might come off the cushion first here, actually. He's got the red to the yellow pocket, but of course he'll be leaving the other one, so he might just play this cushion first. On the other hand, he could put the white to the top cushion. Well, that gentleman certainly wasn't going to go quietly, Dave. I think you can still hear him in the background, just slightly.
Got a voice louder than Brian Blessed.
Well, here we go then. Well, he knew that was all or nothing. Again, he hasn't refused a lot this evening.
3. 4. 5.
Could split a few here, stay on the lone red. Oh, he's just got into the white a little bit too much there. It's gone towards the side cushion. 11. Now, there's a little bit of pressure on this one. Not only to pot the red, but to get onto the black.
12.
Played it well, but he's lost the white again. And this is another tough pot to take on.
12. Don't need this stage of a major semi-final.
Doesn't have to take it on, he could refuse it. But if he drops this in dead weight, he could play a red to the corner. Well, he's gone with power, and we knew it was very missable.
Mark Allen, 12.
Actually, to be honest, I think he might have got away with it.
It was tough, particularly the way he played it. But as you say, it could have been a lot worse. Well, he's looking at the plant here. Just didn't quite make it. Well, there's just nothing being turned down, is there?
No, the last couple of frames have been really strange.
One.
It's certainly a sort of match that will suit both players. They're both attacking. Don't necessarily like matches with lots of safety in. Well, there hasn't been much in this one.
He won't be best pleased, though, because he knows he should be putting on here towards the winning line and... Well, okay, heavy contact, but yeah, Sean sitting in his chair, he's thinking, well, come on, you know, I'm in good position here.
8. Sixteen. 17. 22.
Play that one nicely, just on the spot red, leave an angle on the black to get into them. 23. Don't think there's any loose ones there you can play on. I think you'll need 30. A cannon of some sort here from the black.
31.
Well, this is a key shot now. I don't know if these two reds were planned. If they are, he'll play a cannon on the right-hand red. just check them. Obviously they are a cannon. They are a plant, I should say.
38.
Well, I thought he played on the plant.
39.
I think he slightly disturbed one of the reds and maybe just knocked it off being a plant.
All right. Well, not easy from here, but he could play this with top spin right hand side, two cushions, and nudge something. Yeah, they look like they're set to the side cushion, aren't they? Unlucky. Well,
46.
Sometimes you've got to say that the management there was not good.
Well, he's got a 58-point lead. Now, this is a good time to play a good safety. Put all the pressure on Murphy. He's realistically looking for one more chance, and that's the chance he's trying to get from this safety shot. But the other side is don't leave a long red on, because if he does, Murphy will take it on for sure.
Mark Allen, 46.
Thank you. Well, he's caught the ground, and there is a red out there, but it's not easy. Not quite yet. Sorry, there yet over the line in this one. Another good safety required here. Would have really have liked to put that red tight to the cushion. That's what his intention was. Yeah, that's a better one from Sean Murphy. Unbelievable. I mean, he thought hard and long before he committed himself, but I mean, how good a cueing is that? I mean, it was bang in the middle. And I've noticed as well these days with Sean, David, that when he's cueing up to the ball, what we call the waggles with the cue, he's at least like two or three. It's not as if it's five, six or seven on really important shots. Even with that red, it was the same. It was like two, bang. back, three bang in.
Yes, he's still got the confidence in his game, even though Allen's made this a lot closer. I mean, he was not far from making it 4-4 there, but he's still playing that same attacking game.
And how good was that red to get in?
Yeah, superb. And what a chance. And this is a big moment now, isn't it? Because 58-0 to Allen, but Sean Murphy in with a chance 5-3. A good chance you've got to take.
And a few minutes ago, when Mark tried to play that safety off the red on the right-hand side there that was near the pink, he's now wishing that he had got that red tight to the cushion. Because he can get in behind this and just and drop in for the blue.
12. Nineteen.
Good play to another red here. Cushion first, he'll land on the other one. Not bad. He's got it to the middle. He can come down
25.
For the pink. Here.
26.
What's he done there? Was that just a misjudgment or was that a bad kick? Trying to slide by the red, of course, for the pink. You might have just got enough of a kick for it to sort of throw a wide angle.
Flat ball. Sean Murphy, 26.
Oh, that's clever. Bringing the black to play and laying the snooker at the same time. So all of a sudden, Mark has to be very careful now. Because this guy's at 32 behind. Look at this. Let's have a look at this again. Well, I think that was probably a bad contact, and it threw the cue ball into the red. Got to get this safe. Could have been worse, but it's on. And there's no doubt that he'll be going for this. But the yellow and the green are no good to him. He needs at least the blue. He could play on the brown, but it's at the other end of the table. He'll be having a go at this. Missed it. Now where's it going to finish? Will the yellow come to his rescue? The answer is no. Well, all the hard work that Sean got to do to get back into the frame is to no avail, and Mark Allen here would be absolutely delighted.
Mark Allen, one.
Two snookers needed. It's looking like four apiece.
Well, obviously it doesn't help his cause that he snookered himself. Great hit. But he has left a chance on.
Yeah, imagine if he just nudged the brown on the way through there. This yellow then to really make sure of this frame and level the match up. Well, he needed another chance at the end there, Mark, and he got it. I think that kick on the second red for Sean didn't help.
Well, he's done well. He was 4-2 down and under pressure. OK, the frames haven't necessarily been clean, but it looks like he's won them. Murphy continuing, but it's going to be tough from here. He needs three snookers. He's in another one himself. It's starting to look like a best of three now to reach the final. Well, that's a snooker, but green close to the cushion. It's quite a big target there. Murphy, though, well within his rights to give this a go, because you never know, if you could get one, then it just puts a bit of pressure on. Disappointed there. There was a big target to get a snooker. And then can Mark Allen knock the green in and get this time one once and for all? Well, he's played the snooker. This time.
Mark Allen, three, and a three.
So we're level at 4-4. Sean Murphy led 3-1, he led 4-2. Mark Allen has done well to come back, and this match firmly in the balance with a possible three frames remain. They both need two to take on Ricky Walden in the Players' Championship final tomorrow. Sean Murphy and Mark Allen level at four frames all.
На Евроспорт.
4-4 then, and Sean Murphy has left the arena between frames. You've got to say he'll be a little concerned. He's been going for his shots, but none of them have been going in. But he did seem to be in control at 4-2. Mark Allen was looking a little bit edgy at that point, but he's kept going, he's kept leaving, and he's still there with a great chance now, four apiece. Possible three frames left, and the match in the balance. The final is a two-session affair. It's 2 o'clock CET, 8 o'clock CET tomorrow. They play nine frames in the afternoon, a possible ten at night. So it's first to ten. The winner takes £100,000. The runner-up 38, losing semi-final 20 tonight. Mark Allen not in China, so this is his last event before the World Championship. Not in the China Open in Beijing. Sean Murphy will fly on Monday, regardless of what happens here over the next hour or so, and indeed possibly tomorrow. And then, of course, after the China Open, which, by the way, is live all 7 days, starting here on Eurosport, attention turned to the World Championship. First of all, qualifiers at Ponds Forge in Sheffield, and then the Crucible itself, April the 16th. 3 weeks today, we'll have all 17 days live on Eurosport. But right now, we're just waiting for Sean Murphy to come back. The crowd wondering what's going to happen next. I don't think Murphy will change his strategy, but the question is, are enough of them going to go in? Because at one point, he was a big favourite, but now we're level.
Well, that's a better break-off shot, because the one that he played when he came back from the interval was not good. Well, I wonder if he's pushed one out here. This might go. Well, I think it will. Yes, it's, if it was straight on the red, fair enough, but he's attacking it from an angle. Hence safety. Well, a great return from Art there. This is trouble. And one more, he might be forced into a pot. Okay, he left the pot on, but he's very close to the red with the cue ball, and no, there's not much angle there to get out for the black. The danger is he could push this. I don't think there's much percentage in this. Well, he thinks he's got enough angle here to just tuck this in the corner and get out for the black. It's got to be a clean hit though. Well, he was. Done quite well there, but he couldn't guarantee himself a good position on the back. So if he takes his black on, there's pressure on this one. This is very missable. He's played it dead weight, and he's knocked it bang in the middle of the pocket. How good was that?
8.
Well, Mark Allen perhaps growing in confidence now. He's made it all square because he knows that, particularly that last frame, Merv had a chance to make it 5-3. He had chances in the previous one as well.
9.
Well, the red was good, wasn't it? But the black was even better, wasn't it? I mean, dead weight. That was all or nothing.
Twenty-four.
Well, for the first time this evening then, a chance to put his nose in front.
Thank you.
And if you're not right on your A game, these are the sort of challenges you have to take on and just and try and stick in there. I mean, he's played really well in this match in patches, but like both players, they've missed a few as well.
32.
It's not been a bad match by any means. It's been of quality.
This is the sixth black coming up. The price from maximum is 10,000, but the sponsors, Ladbrokes, have said they will match that. So effectively it's 20. Mark Allen, one of the few top 16 players yet to make one in a professional competition. He has made two 146s though, including one at the Crucible.
Needs to go. I don't think he's got there. He might have to play 48. The one into the yellow pocket. No, shake of the head, he hasn't got there. So it's this one to the yellow pocket then. Okay. We've got a match on our hands now. First four frames were brilliant, and then we had a couple of edgy ones and that, but hang on. Ooh, he was up off that one as well a bit quick. And he just dropped in.
52.
He thought he'd missed that. Because he put the green in the corner of the pocket, he hasn't landed ideally on a red. Yeah, well done. This is not ideal either. Would have been okay if the cue ball was slightly off the cushion, but the reds are going to the left corner rather than the right hand corner. Decided to play on the back of them.
58.
Red to the left middle there. Well, these are never easy from these angles. He's playing he's thinking about playing the right hand one to the corner, I think. He's not taking it to the middle, he's taking it to the corner. Well, he's made a good 58 there, but it might not be enough. If you get the green, red, blue, well, he's taking the blue first, or thinking about it, I was thinking green, red, blue. He's 68 the lead, 67 on.
What a cracking pot that was from Mark Allen. And there's no doubt at the moment he is the better player of the two and looks the more confident. But, well, he's still on the red, but it's one of those.
Yeah, I thought he'd snookered himself with the brown there.
Four.
Well, he needs the blue or the black off this red. Probably will be the black.
He needs the red first.
Yeah, exactly.
Five.
Well, I didn't think he'd play it that way. I don't think he did play it that way, to be honest. So the black is frame ball. Doesn't need to play on the red tiers. Make sure the black take the cue ball away from them, even if he misses. Well done. Well, and I'm with you, David. He is beginning to look the better player now. He looks confident.
Frame six, he looked edgy, and he lost that frame, and he trailed 4-2. And we said at the time, frame seven was big, but he's now won. Three on the spin, barring, of course, snookers here. And it looks like it's going to be Mark Allen. Frame from victory.
Although it's only one snooker required. This has to go in. Well, frame over, I'm afraid.
Pressure now on Murphy, who was in control at one point.
Well.
And credit to Mark Allen. His temperament's been excellent. It's not been big breaks necessarily, but he's been standing up, and that is half the battle in this game, particularly at a vital stage of a big
six
match like this.
Yeah, just kept chipping away, kept believing.
Seven. Fourteen. 15.
Well, he can't get them quick enough now.
Twenty-one.
Be interesting if he plays Ricky Walden in the final, because they've got five ranking titles between them,
22.
All in China. So neither one of them have won a big tournament in the UK. You never know in snooker these days. You can pick any two of
28.
About 25 players to reach a final.
29.
Standards are so high across the board. Mark Allen hasn't played his best snooker this week, but he's starting to look good now, and he's starting to feel good, more importantly.
35. 37. Forty-four. 49.
So three in a row for the Northern Irishman.
55.
This match has swung round. As the black goes in, 62 clearance to add 50 and made earlier in the frame. And Sean Murphy, who was in full control, or so it seemed, 4-2, is now the man under pressure. It's Mark Allen who needs one to reach the final tomorrow. Leads Murphy. 5-4 to Mark Allen. This time it's he who has left the arena, geeing himself up for one more frame. Sean Murphy led 4-2, but he's now got it all to do here. And the bottom line is not enough have been going in. He's still going for his shots. That's the approach he's had all evening, but Mark Allen is potting more at the moment.
Yeah, that's the approach he's had all for the last couple of weeks. So food for thought then for the Englishman. Mark must be feeling great inside. Just waiting for him to return before we get this next frame underway. Good crowd in, created a good atmosphere here this evening, but I'm sure they'll like to see another couple of frames. Well, he knows what he has to do anyway. So does this guy.
Thank you, frame 10. Mark Allen to break.
So Mark Allen is now in front, 5-4. One more for victory and a place in the final.
Yeah, it's got the cover of the green. Now it's up to this man to respond now. No, that's not overly clever. And he's just got the cue ball past the ball line, but his left red's on. Well, one. Good one, anyway. A chance to get in. Well, he tried to play it with an element of safety, but unfortunately, he's seen that red go over middle. Sean looking to capture that sort of form that he showed in the first two or three frames.
One.
Well, he's not really made any breaks of any note since the interval, but this would be a good time to make amends for that.
Yeah, looking to get amongst these reds near the black spot if he can and just clear things at this end of the table.
Brown ball.
Probably come down the left-hand side of the table here. Slow down. Might still be on a red, but he wanted to be high on it. The blue's off his spot. Now he's just checking the pink.
Six.
Yes, he's got some angle on the pink to get over for the reds. Might take a risk here, actually, just play the cannon into the red near the black. Just pop this with a little bit of left-hand side on the cue ball. Shouldn't have to, because the pink is available now.
Well, yeah.
Question is, will he take the risk or just go back for the pink? That is the percentage shot. Didn't like that one. It's gone to number two.
Thirteen.
Well done. But if anything, he just caught the red a little bit on the full side. He could have done with that half ball. But he can hold the white into the pack again here, four reds. Oh, but make sure of the black. Well, that was always wide. Will that be his last shot?
One.
Yeah, I think there's still another red there at the edge of the pack. Well, there isn't. So he's overdone that slightly. Yes, well done.
Nice.
Lovely pot. Green possibly into the pack. That would be really aggressive. He's playing the brown.
Foul.
Oh.
Mark Allen 9 for Sean Murphy.
Well, anyway, but there. Bit of a miscalculation there. And of course, the cue ball next to the green, this red is possible. Well, you did mention it, David, since that interval, Sean's been nowhere near that he was in the first two or three frames. I know Mark knocked the 1-3 for him, but before the interval, he was pretty good. And again, let's look at that. I mean, Mark's has gone up 55%, and Sean's has played, or stayed, pretty much the same, if not lower. So his long game this evening, apart from one or two pots, has not been the norm. But he has knocked one or two really good long reds in, but that was the one that that went begging there.
Thank you.
That's pretty good. Might have to come off the left-hand cushion here, dead weight into the pack. Can't risk doing anything else, really. Well, I think he's looking to just skim off the red here and just miss the mid pocket, try and get the white down towards this top cushion. He's going to have to be ultra careful. Looking at that other red of the stopper, so I can only assume that he's going to be this is going to be downward striking and trying to get the cue ball back to the back cushion, but that's tough. Nearly 2 minutes thinking time. Well, you can see that he doesn't like it. You can understand the time being taken, and at this juncture our referee will not intervene. Well, that would have been brilliant if they'd gone in. But now it might be very costly.
One.
Chance here for the Irishman then to put this match away. He's been patient here this evening.
Eight.
As I said before, he's just been sort of chipping away. Now he has a chance to win the match. Could go into them. I think he will the next one.
14.
Just wonder if there's actually a red at the edge of the pack there. He's still got the one down the table for a little bit of insurance if you need. No, the one at the edge won't go.
15.
Well, he'll have to go down for the red down the table now. I think his game plan, well, he could have done with a little bit of reverse side. His game plan was to possibly get onto the brown here and then go into the pack. But he hasn't finished good on this red.
Callan, 21.
Well, a couple of occasions to get a good angle on the pink there to go into the pack. Didn't do so. And now if Sean could knock this red in and get onto the brown, he could have split the pack. But of late, these have not been going in. That's better. Well, it could be about this shot now. He's actually got a good angle on the green as well. I think it might be the brown. Stun off the top cushion with a little bit of right-hand side. It's a big target, but he could miss them. Unlucky. Oh, well, you must have expected something from that.
Sean Murphy, 5.
Well, there's still the question, of course, are we going into a decider? They're hoping so. I think this match deserves a decider, actually. So close, but he's got the cover. Just at the moment, things are going well for that man. Oh, sorry, I thought he got the snooker. He hasn't. From the other camera angle, it looked like it was a snooker. I think he was trying to kill the white at this end for the pink, but it's okay. A chance then to put us into that decider. But still pressure on these. Struck that beautifully.
Eight.
Scores a level. Four reds, four pinks, and Mark will need a snooker. He might not get the chance to play for them, actually. Well, he shouldn't do. Oh, he's gone back for one of the other colours. So he will need probably yellow and green, which is not a real problem.
Thirteen.
Well, it's not an ideal angle. It would have been okay if the black wasn't there. But he had the room to go around it. He's played it well. Yes, again, he's just left it a little bit near to the side cushion.
19.
They're wanting this match to go into a decider.
20. Sean Murphy, 27.
Oh, would you believe that? Only needed the red and the black. Would have been 27 the lead, 27 on. Done all the hard work. There's no way he would have missed the black. There's no way he wouldn't have gone on the yellow. A bit question here for Mark Allen. Is it, will he go for this and go for frame a match? He might do. It's a big decision to make. Unbelievable. I think it was one of those, really, in as much that it was difficult to get safe from, so he might as well have a go. And that might have just won him this match and put him into the final tomorrow.
Great red.
Well, the way Sean Murphy started this match, it looked at one stage, it could be an early night for him, 2-0, but I think frame three was significant. Mark Allen made a 1-3-4, and he just reminded everybody, no, hang on, there is a match on. And since the interval, although it's not been massive breaks flying in, he's stood up well, and that red he's just knocked in there says a lot about him as a character. Just got to finish it off now.
Yeah, he thought about it, didn't he? He thought, come on, let's have a go. Worst case scenario is that it's 5-all.
Just a little kick on the green.
I could have done with being over a little bit more than that. And he knows it. I thought he might have just powered that in a little bit more. At this stage, this is missable. But he hasn't missed it. But he's finished a little bit low on the pink, which means he's got to go around the table with the cue ball. He needs pink and black. Now there are pockets waiting here if he doesn't get this right.
Well, it was already tough, but it's just tough. He's got, first of all, got to pop the pink, but also got to go around the table, get on the black.
Oh yeah, our little friend has appeared just at the wrong moment, to be honest. Just waiting to sort of fly off and get out of the way before he takes this on.
Big shot. Look at the face there. They can barely watch.
He's played it well. He's caught it well off the back cushion. This looks absolutely perfect. Well, every credit here to Mark Allen.
Well, again, a great shot, just like Reddy knocked in to get in. What a turnaround. You fall two down. But he's in the finals. What a win that is for Mark Allen. It was a battle. Sean Murphy warmly congratulates him. I think that was a great example of his temperament there. Never stopped believing, never stopped trying, even when things went awkward. Again, on the pink there, that was a tough shot, but he negotiated it well, knocking in the black. Mark Allen will play Ricky Walden in the Players' Championship final. He's beaten Sean Murphy 6-4.